Hello guys, welcome to today's video. So today we'll be discussing another chapter, which is chapter 15 of the book. So in this chapter we'll be discussing the categories of aircraft or the aircraft categories. You know, there are many types of aircrafts. First we'll try to understand the different types of aircrafts that are used in aviation, starting with the combi aircraft. You know, combi aircraft in commercial aviation are aircraft that can be used to carry either the passengers as an airliner or cargo as a freighter. You know, you have to remember, anything which carries the passenger is the airliner and cargo as a freighter, and sometimes they can be used as a both. So whenever if in the options you are getting that both passenger as well as cargo are traveling, then it will refer to as a combi aircraft. Next is a normal airliner. You know, airliner is an aircraft for transporting the passengers and air cargo. You know, in normal civil aviation, you know, passengers will be traveling and their luggage as well as sometimes the cargo also will be carrying. So these type of aircrafts are known as airliners. These are the mostly used aircrafts in aviation. So these aircrafts are often operated by the airlines. The definition of airliners actually vary from country, but then typically you can say that airplane intended for carrying multiple passengers or cargo in a commercial service. So carrying multiple passengers or cargo can be referred to as an airliner. Cargo aircraft is also known as a freight aircraft or freighter, airlifter or cargo jet. These are some of the other names of cargo aircraft. Most important are the freight and the freighter. You know, these are the normal used terms for the cargo aircraft. So normally these are designed such that they are carrying for the carriage of cargo rather than the passengers. You know, normal aircrafts are designed for passengers, whereas for transporting materials or the cargo items, these cargo aircrafts are designed. In this, what will happen is inside the aircraft, it will be empty space only, so that many of the materials can be put. There will be no seating, no seats available normally in a normal airliner. These are designed to carry only the materials. So such aircraft usually do not incorporate passenger amenities and generally feature one or more large doors for loading of the cargo. So they don't have facilities like seating, toilets and many other things, you know. And also they will be having many doors so that for loading and unloading of the materials it will be easy. This you can remember, cargo aircraft. Next is aircraft cabin. You know, inside the aircraft where the passenger will actually be sitting, you know, that is referred to as the cabin. Aircraft cabin. So aircraft cabin, the definition is a section of an aircraft in which passengers travel. The very passengers will be sitting, so that area will be referred to as the cabin. So normally, you know, since aircraft fly at a higher altitudes, 30,000 feet or 25,000 feet, so what happens is at this elevation, the air pressure is less. So to maintain a normal air pressure and for oxygen breathing, you know, these cabins are pressurized. This you have to remember. All the aircraft cabins are pressurized as cruising altitudes. Cruising altitudes mean the flying altitudes, the flying heights. As I said, 30,000 to 25,000. At this altitude, what happens, the atmosphere is too thin or passengers to breathe. So that is the reason the aircraft cabin will be pressurized. So this is an important term. Next is, there are different types of aviation terms, you know. One is general aviation, military aviation and then civil aviation. Knowing the difference between them is important. So we'll start with the general aviation. So general aviation includes all non-scheduled civil flying, which include both private as well as a commercial. So non-scheduled civil flying is the important key term. So what will this include is, they can include the business flights, private air charters, private aviation, flight training, balloon, paragliding, parachuting and many other things, you know, which are non-scheduled civil flying. All these will come under the category of general aviation. This you have to remember. Next is military aviation. Military aviation, as the term itself says, military. So for military aircrafts, which are other than used for the civil aircrafts, then those can be categorized as military, for the military purposes. You know, other flying machines for the purpose of conducting or enabling aerial warfare. I mean, this is an aerial fight, like fighter planes and all, including the national airlift, including the air cargo. You know, Indian Air Force also has some planes which are mainly used for cargos. And then those will also come under the category of military aviation, since they are used for the purpose of military. So air cargo is to provide logistic supply to the forces stationed in war theater or along the front. So generally you can remember that anything which is used for military purposes or defense can be categorized as a military aviation. Next is the civil aviation, which is normally the passengers, and the general aviation is a civil aviation. So civil aviation has two categories. Civil aviation represents two major categories, that is non-military aviation, which are both private and commercial. Most of the countries in the world are the members of ICAO. You know, ICAO, all members are civil aviation. This stands for Industrial Civil Aviation Organization. So all the civil aviation members states are a part of ICAO. So what are the two important categories of civil aviation? You know, one is the scheduled transport, which includes all passengers and cargo flights operating on regularly scheduled routes. This is one. Another is a general category, includes all civil flights, private or commercial. So this is the civil aviation. So definition you can remember like this, you know, civil, general and military. Military is primary for military only. General is non-scheduled aircrafts, whereas civil has non-scheduled as well as the scheduled. So this is the difference between these three, you know, this table. AAI is a mostly, it operates under the civil aviation. So it includes both non-scheduled as well as the scheduled aircrafts. So now what is meant by scheduled and non-scheduled? You know, scheduled services are the flights which are scheduled and performed to a published timetable. It means the timetable will be published beforehand and the schedule will be given. So those services are scheduled services, and which are open to direct booking by members of public. You know, normal traditional airlines, traditional flights are scheduled services only. Whereas a non-scheduled is the one for which there is no schedule given. They will fly just a few hours before they will mention and they will fly. Whereas scheduled services, beforehand only they will give the timetable. Whereas for non-scheduled, there is no fixed timetable. So this is the basic difference between scheduled and non-scheduled. Next is charter flights. You might have heard private business people and all, they will be having a separate flight which they own. These are charter flights. So these are don't have any schedule fixed, because businessmen, whenever they want to travel, they will travel. So these are all non-scheduled operation. This you can remember. All charter flights are non-scheduled. Next is coming to the maintenance. You know, aircrafts also needs to be carry a maintenance activities so that they are always up to the mark. I mean, they have all the safety measures taken. For that, maintenance is required. So what I mentioned is the performance of tasks required to ensure the continuing airworthiness of aircraft, including one of the combination inspection, replacement, defection. And this is a general definition of maintenance, which also is applicable for the aircrafts also. Like how our bikes and car needs to be maintained, likewise aircrafts also needs to be maintained so that they have the airworthiness of the aircraft. There is nothing much specific about it, you know. Next is, now we have understood various steps of aviation and then the types of aircrafts, then we'll just move on to the different categories of aircraft. You know, aircrafts are categorized based on different characteristics, and then they are grouped based on the many features. Let's say if they are categorized based on the use or operating limitations. So these are the seven types they have defined: transport, normal, utility, acrobatic, limited, restricted, provisional. Similarly, grouping of aircrafts having a propulsion. You know, aircrafts use a propulsion system for thrust. So depending on them, there are the types of aircraft grouping is done. Next is based on the certification of the pilots, ratings, limitations of airmen, I mean how many people can travel, and the pilot categories. These are defined in these four. About the different categories, I have made a video. You can click on the link above. It will take you to that video so that you will understand more about these in detail. So if you have liked the video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more videos. And thank you for watching.